Good morning, everyone. This is Kaolin Kamikawa, CO2 reduction, COP26. While the world is fluttering in neighboring South Korea, a new infection with the new coronavirus is spreading again. I don't like it. In South Korea, the number of new infections per day due to the new coronavirus has increased since November 10. It has been over 2,000 people. There were 2,125 people on November 16. In Japan, the number of infected people has continued to decrease, reaching 74 on November 16. On the other hand, the severely ill in South Korea, there were 411 people on the 6th of this month, and 485 people on the 13th after reaching the 400 level for the first time. It exceeds 400 people every day and continues to increase. The number of seriously ill people in Japan continues to decrease to 82 on November 16. Similarly, the dead South Korea continues to grow with 22 people on November 15. Japan continues to decline with 4 people on November 16. Do you think this difference is one thing? Moreover, looking at this graph, while Japan shows a movement close to a perfect normal distribution, the Korean graph is distorted, and it's a suspicious movement, isn't it? Are you counting properly? Even in the form of the graph, Japan and South Korea are moving completely differently. After all, Japan and South Korea are different countries, aren't they? Even if you look at the vaccination rate, in South Korea, the complete, twice, inoculation rate is 77.9% and the one-time inoculation rate is 81.61% based on this day. Complete, twice, inoculation rates are higher than 57.3% in the United States, 67.36% in the United Kingdom, and 75.04% in Japan. It is the second highest level in the world after 80.08% of Spain, which is the first in the world. While saying that the vaccine is not enough at one time, before you know it, you are overtaking Japan and the world and boasting the highest inoculation rate in the world, right? But in other countries, as vaccination rates increase, the number of infected people does not decrease. The basic movement is to reduce the number of severely ill and dead. Why are the number of seriously ill and dead people increasing in South Korea? It is weird, is not it? What kind of vaccine would South Korea do like this? You might want to wonder, don't you hit a fake? Excuse me, also, South Korea praised itself as K-quarantine, right? Korea's epidemic prevention principle is extensive diagnostic test, epidemiological investigation and transmission route tracking, trace, rapid treatment, treat, you said, 3T, which means 3T, and praised yourself. You were proud that you could control the infection without the vaccine, right? Does that mean it didn't work for Delta stocks? It would be a little embarrassing if the Korean government still boasts K-quarantine. What was the Korean vaccine used for? I did some research, but Pfizer 21.138, 304 people. AstraZeneca 11,012, 316, including 1,762,929 Pfizer cross inoculation subjects. Moderna 6,173,700 people. Janssen 1,493,090 people. Well, there are only a few made in China, so it's hard to think that the vaccine was bad. I don't know how it was handled, but if it's a decent country, you're hitting it properly, right? Would you please check the vaccine usage rate of infected people once? I would like to request your report as soon as possible. In fact, South Korea is shifting to gradual daily recovery with corona from the 1st of this month. With the transition to with corona, the restrictions on the number of private gatherings have been relaxed. Up to 10 people are allowed in the metropolitan area, and up to 12 people in other areas. Restaurants and cafes are now open 24 hours a day. I've been told, isn't this the cause? The Korean government said that the conversion to with corona, it seems that it will continue to be mitigated by implementing it in 3 stages every 6 weeks. Following the current first stage, in the second stage from December 13, we will consider lifting the obligation to wear masks outdoors. In the third stage from January 24 next year, the plan is to lift all restrictions on facility management, event implementation, and private gatherings. Even though the number of infected people is increasing, it is impossible in Japan to do this. In Japan, there is a person called Chairman OMI, who is the government opinion number. It is a situation where it is difficult to take steps to deregulate. I would like to lend Mr. OMI to you www. In any case, on the other hand, Korea seems to be useful as a teacher. That's all.
South Korea had the highest number of critical cases to date since the outbreak of the pandemic in this country. The trend is starting to strain the healthcare system, particularly in the capital region. However, authorities say the current situation is still manageable. Kim Yeon-sung brings us the updates.
A record high level of critical cases. The country on Tuesday reported 495 patients in critical condition, staying above 400 for the 11th day in a row. Health authorities said earlier that they would pull the brakes on the further easing of restrictions if data points to the nation heading towards a full-on health crisis. Some of the warning signs they mentioned were if there are more than 500 severe patients, or if the nation's ICU units are at more than 75% of maximum capacity. The country isn't far off those levels, with more than three-quarters of ICU beds in the capital region already in use. But health authorities say that the current situation is still manageable. For now, health authorities will redirect patients to where there's more room and try to acquire more ICU beds. But if they find the health system is close to being overwhelmed, they will enact a contingency plan, the details of which will be announced on Wednesday afternoon. South Korea has also seen over 2,000 daily cases for a week, with 2,125 new infections recorded on Tuesday.
While there are only 8% of people in their 60s and over who are not fully vaccinated, they made up 61.7% of the total 452 deaths from October 3rd to November 6th.
In other words, unvaccinated people aged over 60 make up around 3% of the country's population, but more than 60% of the deaths came from that group. Kim Yeon-sung, Arirang News.